Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have 9 topics to cover, so let's get started. The Google Meet API has graduated from the Developer Preview Program and is now generally available. The Meet API enables you to programmatically create and manage meetings in Google Meet and offers entry points to your users directly from your app. With the Google Meet API, you can do the following. Create a meeting space. Get a meeting space or conference by resource name. Get a list of participants and participant sessions. Get meeting artifacts like recordings, transcripts, and transcript entries. A change announced by email in December 2023 to members of the Developer Preview Program specifying spaces space ID change from the previous version has now gone into effect. Requests using meeting space resource names with the old meeting space IDs are now rejected. The ability to subscribe to Google Meet events through the Google Workspace Events API has also graduated from the Developer Preview Program and is now generally available. The Google Workspace Events API lets you subscribe to meeting spaces and users. My colleague Allison made a video about how you can use this API to be notified when a relevant event occurs. I recommend you watch it to learn more about the ability to subscribe to Google Meet events. The Google Meet Add-ons SDK is currently available through the Developer Preview Program. Please note that the Get Current Meeting Recording Status method has been deprecated. There isn't a replacement method to get this data. Google Chat Apps now support Google Apps Script's card service. If you've built your chat app using Apps Script, you can use the card service to build user interfaces such as card messages and dialogues. On screen, you see an example of building a card. On the left side, you see how this is done in JSON, and on the right, how the same is done using the new Apps Script card service. This new feature is made available through the Developer Preview Program. The events.watch method now supports the event types field as a query parameter. This enables you to subscribe to changes about specific calendar events, such as working location, focus time, or out of office events, which is what you see on screen right now. The use of event type filters will be considered when reviewing quota increase requests. Before you request a quota increase, make sure you specify the event types you need as a parameter for your application. Both events.list and events.watch will use the same default event type filter. The default optional query parameters for both methods is default, focus time, out of office, working location. To help with error handling, error messages will be returned when unsupported operations are attempted on special event types, such as working location, out of office, and focus time events. Please note that this change and the 2 previous ones will take effect as of March 11th, 2024. Let us know in the comments section below. Which new feature are you most excited about trying out? Make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you stay up to date with all things Google Workspace platform related.